The graphics on the Quest 2 have always looked soft or a little blurry to me. Don't get me wrong, I think the Quest 2 is an amazing piece of hardware. I wouldn't have made so much content about it if I didn't. At its price point, there's nothing else out there right now that even comes close to its capabilities. But that hasn't stopped me from wanting games on it to look a little sharper. Something a little more like this. Yes, this is running natively on the Quest 2. It looks really good, doesn't it? I've been reading a lot of stuff online and have watched a lot of videos with people giving tips on how to improve the graphics on the Quest 2. And recently I found a way that wasn't just adjusting the IPD or adjusting the headset on your face or making sure your lenses are clean. You can actually increase the resolution games are rendered at, making them look noticeably sharper and clearer. There are, of course, some hoops to jump through and some tools we're going to need to do this, but it's actually all fairly simple. The first thing you're going to need to do is go to dashboard.oculus.com on your PC and register your Oculus account as a developer. I've placed a link to this page in the video description and it'll take you right there. If you aren't already logged into your Oculus or Facebook account on your computer, you'll need to do that, and then you'll click in this field here and type in the name of your organization. You are free to name your organization whatever you want, and then you'll want to check the little I understand box here and then click submit. If you're using a Windows PC, you'll then need to download and install the Oculus ADB drivers to your PC. If you're on Mac or Linux, you do not need to worry about this step. I've placed the link to the drivers on Oculus's developer site in the video description, which looks like this, and you'll want to click on the big blue download button, check I have read and agree to the terms of license box, and then click download. Once you have downloaded the driver, you'll want to unzip the file, open this folder, then open this USB driver folder and right click on this Android_WinUSB.inf file and click install. Once you have the driver installed, you'll want to restart your PC and then grab your smartphone or tablet for the next step. We now need to enable developer mode on our Quest 2. To do this, you'll want to make sure your Quest 2 is turned on and connected to the same Wi-Fi network as your phone, and that your phone's Bluetooth connection is turned on. Now we can open the Oculus app on our phone. Tap on Menu here at the bottom, then on Devices, and if we scroll down a little bit, we'll see Developer Mode here in the settings. Tap on that, and then toggle this little switch on. The next step is to install an application called SideQuest to our PC. SideQuest is similar to the Oculus app in that it's a place where you can browse and purchase different games for the Quest 2, many of which are not available on the official Oculus store. Since it isn't officially supported by Oculus, any apps you get on SideQuest will have to be sideloaded onto your Quest 2 and accessed through this drop-down in your app's menu and found under unknown sources. But that's not what this video is a tutorial for, so anyway, SideQuest also offers some additional tools, which is what we're going to be using to increase the resolution of our games. Just like with everything else, I've placed a link to SideQuest's download page in the video description for your convenience. Depending on what operating system you have on your PC, you'll select the version of SideQuest you want accordingly. Most of you are probably running Windows PCs, so we'll click on that, and the download will begin. Once you've downloaded SideQuest, you'll want to launch the installation file and follow the on-screen prompts to install it. You'll then want to launch SideQuest on your PC and connect your Quest 2 to your PC using a USB cable. You'll then need to put on your headset and you should see this message to allow USB debugging. If you don't want to have to click allow on this every time you connect your headset, then you'll want to click always allow from this computer. And then you'll see this message asking if you want to allow your PC to access data on your Quest 2. And I typically click allow on this. You don't have to click allow here, but I always do because then I can browse the files on my Quest 2 using Windows Explorer. Now when we look at SideQuest, we should have a green circle in the upper left-hand corner of the window like this, letting us know our headset is connected, and it should say Oculus Quest 2, its network IP address, and the current battery level. Now we're finally ready to do what we came here to do. At the top of the SideQuest window, you'll want to click on this wrench icon. And in this menu, we have a bunch of different settings we can try out and play with. For this tutorial though, there's only one we're the most interested in, and that is this one here toward the bottom of the list called Default Texture Size. Basically, this setting can increase or decrease the resolution games on the Quest 2 are rendered at. You're welcome to try out any or all the different settings, but the one I found that increases the graphics quality without really affecting the frame rate is 2048. 2560 of course looks even better, and for the most part the games I tested with ran fairly well at 2560, but I did notice the frame rate wasn't quite as smooth. And if you try to cast to your phone or a TV at this resolution, the performance really begins to tank. That being said, if you want to see just how sharp and clear the display on the Quest 2 can be, I totally recommend cranking it up to 3072 just to see how good things look. But be aware, you will see a huge impact to the frame rate. Every game I tried was unplayable, in my opinion, at this resolution, but man, did they look amazing. The one big caveat to this is the settings are only temporary. As far as I know, there is no way to permanently implement these settings. As long as you don't reboot your Quest 2 or power it all the way down though, the settings will remain in place. But as soon as you reboot, everything will be set back to normal. On the bright side, if you change settings and end up with some really wonky stuff going on, all you have to do is reboot or power down your Quest 2 and power it back up again, and everything should be all good. You can play around with some of the other stuff, like the fixed foveated rendering, which the higher you set it, puts less strain on the CPU and GPU because it allows them to render the stuff around the edges at a lower resolution while leaving the stuff you're concentrated on in the center at full resolution. I tried this out at various different levels, and when I was playing a game, I didn't really notice much of a difference to the visuals at all when I set this on the highest setting. Changing the CPU and GPU level may also help some with performance. Level 4 is maximum performance, by the way, but I imagine most games are already running things at this level to get the best performance possible, because I honestly didn't notice any difference in the games I tested it with between leaving it at whatever the game normally has it set at and manually setting it to level 4. So yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching, and have fun.